Mr. Basu, there were some very interesting anecdotes also shared by the governor in his speech today and his statement. You know, he kept on using words like we have an Arjuna's eye on the way the economies are, you know, going, the pace of the growth right there. We are looking at how the global hurricane is going to impact and we'll be nimble footed as far as our actions are concerned as well. What do you make of these kind of statements? I mean, what does it indicate to, you know, our own banking systems as well?
Well, I think nimble-footed is a very apt description of what the RBI has done over the last 2 years. Okay. It has managed the situation remarkably well, and particularly it has managed an unusual period of high global inflation. Globally, inflation is much higher now than at any time in the last four decades. And relative to that, India has actually had a relatively normal period. I mean, India's inflation levels are generally higher than most trading partners. So if you look at the real effective exchange rate, normally the inflation differential is against us. India's inflation is higher than trading partner inflation. This year, India's inflation rate is slightly lower than the average trading partner inflation rate. And so, we've had some modest depreciation of the nominal effective exchange rate, but in real terms, there's been modest appreciation, as the governor pointed out. So we have I think the RBI has demonstrated its nimble-footedness through this, and it had to be particularly nimble-footed in dealing with the fact that it was outside its inflation target and needed to provide an explanation to the government. Yeah. I think the explanation was reasonably sound, given that global inflation was a lot higher than normal. And of course, we had the Russia-Ukraine war adding to inflationary pressures. So all of that, the current RBI regime has actually acquitted itself very well over the last 2 years. And I think India is about to, now is almost out of the woods in terms of dealing with this period of unusually high inflation.
Okay, just last word from you, Mr. Basu, and I'll take it across to Anand as well before we wind up this show. So you believe the rate hike has peaked at this level, 6.25%. A large part, you don't see any rate cuts following. So a pause for how long?
I'd say a pause for at least the next 9 months. And then look at the situation. If inflation continues to moderate, then there will be an argument for rate cuts in the final quarter of calendar year 23, not before then. I mean, given that the global inflation environment hasn't eased off entirely, I don't think the RBI can begin to contemplate cutting interest rates before about September, October next year. Now, if the Russia-Ukraine war ends, for instance, and oil prices moderate quite significantly, then of course there could be an argument for doing it a little bit sooner than that.
Okay.
But really. Unless growth is under threat, I don't think the RBI will be in any hurry to start cutting rates.
If you like the video, do like, comment, share, and subscribe.